What is going on, guys? I thank you all for joining me, and today we're going to be going over Daiwa's mag sealing and how to deal with it should you decide you want to work on your own reel. Now, not everybody has this stuff lying around, but what I want to show you today is that it's not as difficult as people make it seem, and you can easily do it yourself without disrupting the existing seal. So what you're going to need to do, remove the top E-clip or C-clip that holds the bearing and spool support. Once you do that, you'll pull the bearing and the seal out, and you'll have to push this pin out. That will allow you to remove the rest of it, exposing nothing but the shaft, this cosmetic plate here, and the rotor retaining nut. Remove that nut, and there will be a bushing underneath it that generally seats above the pinion on the shaft, and you can now remove the rotor. It's very straightforward and simple, and in order to save time, I figured I'd leave that step out, because this is what you want to see. This blue cap here screws down, and it keeps essentially the entire AR clutch pack fully sealed. From the top down, you can see the pinion, the anti-reverse clutch sleeve, and the magnetic disc. This portion of the magnetic disc is essentially a protective cover that keeps it centered. And without the rotor on this, the AR clutch sleeve, it may not be centered in that gap or that magnetic gap, so you do want to be careful at this point. So what you're going to do now is take this blue cap and counterclockwise slowly unscrew it. You don't want to go too fast, because if there is any buildup or bleed of the ferrofluid or any grease that's in there, you don't want it to lift out the magnet unit prematurely. So once we've got it fully unscrewed, we're going to gently lift it up and out. It's at this point you're now staring at what makes up, what's this stuff called? Mag seal. That's right. You're now staring at what makes up the mag seal unit. Now, what you want to do, if you don't have this stuff lying around, is with three fingers go up and over the main shaft, and with your fingernails, lift up the one side of that magnetic washer. And once you get it as so, you can lift it out. And before you go too far, the AR clutch, which is that piece that pulled out on the bottom, it's not really being held on very tightly by magnetism, so it could fall. Make sure that if you're doing this on your own, you either go like this, or you have a towel below so it doesn't hit the bottom if it falls off and bounce. So right now, you just lifted out the entire assembly. If you want to leave it as is and not lubricate the AR clutch or do anything, you can now remove the screws that hold that pinion bearing in place and service the reel as you normally would. When you're ready to put it back in, to be perfectly honest with you, it's actually easier to take this assembly apart. So you're going to remove the AR clutch bearing by itself. And if you want to clean it out or whatever you want to do, go right ahead. But make sure before you start putting it back together, you put that little eared washer back in place. It makes reassembling much easier. Now you have a couple washers below the mag unit. And it may be easier to take a pick tool and kind of lift it off like that. This is the mag unit itself. It incorporates the AR clutch sleeve and this magnetic washer. And it's really not going to go anywhere because it's held in place by magnetism. So I can shake this around and I'll look real stupid if it falls out, but it's not going anywhere. You know, the magic of magnetism. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place this here out of the way, grab the body of the reel, and start putting this back together, because we're going to pretend we fully open this reel and we're done and ready to put it back together. With this eared washer already in the AR clutch pack, we're going to go ahead and find the larger tooth right there. You'll see there's an ear here, a ear here, and this larger tooth here. And that's going to go right there. If you put the clutch pack in without putting that washer in, you can see those little orange kind of teeth that come out. it's keyed to that washer. It makes it kind of tough to get it back in line. So you want to put that back on the clutch pack before you put it back in the reel. At this point, you can now take the washer with the two ears, place it on top, and it should go in pretty easily. I'd have to rotate the clutch pack a little bit. Good. And that's fully seated. Take your O-ring, place it back where it should go. Since I'm doing this looking at the viewfinder, it's always trickier. Good. Take this non-magnetic washer, at least I think it's non-magnetic, place that over the entire assembly. And you can see it's kind of recessed in. Make sure it goes down all the way. This example is it fully seated. And now, if you're going to leave the AR clutch sleeve and magnetic washer pretty much alone, and you don't have ferrofluid that you want to replace, you can now slide it down, and you can see it is keyed. So sometimes it's easier just to kind of rotate it about so, and it kind of dropped in a little bit. Now, sometimes they're a little stubborn, sometimes they're not. This time around, it went in pretty easily. And I'm pushing down on the AR clutch sleeve before I begin pushing on that magnetic disc. And if you watch before it goes down all the way, it might go in with a little pop, just like that. You're now ready to put this top disc or top cap back in place and clean up any ferrofluid. Now, I was playing around with it quite a bit, and you can see I really didn't disturb much of the ferrofluid. If you wanted to clean it out, all you have to do is use some denatured alcohol and a Q-tip, run it around inside, and while we're at it, I am going to clean it out. Grab a paper towel, double it up since I don't have gloves on because this stuff gets everywhere. Get this O-ring out of the way before I damage it. You can see this stuff makes a mess. You can see I'm not even being gentle with this magnetic portion of the mag seal unit. So, should you have decided to go ahead and clean it out, this is all you're going to need to do. Let me get this back in place like so, and get this top piece back in place like so. We're going to go ahead and grab that O-ring, place it back on top, and because we're being thorough, we're going to clean this washer once again. Pop it over top. Hopefully everything's in frame. Grab our AR clutch sleeve, slide it on down. And since there's no ferrofluid already, I'm not being real considerate as to the order. Pop this back in. I don't know if you showed up on the mic, but it popped when it went back in again. Now that we have that magnetic washer and AR clutch sleeve back in place, we're gonna go ahead now and put the AR clutch cap back in place. You can grease the threads just to make sure it doesn't gall or bind or get stuck. Make sure it's tight. And now take your mystical, magical ferrofluid and a straw. I like using little coffee stirrer type straws. And a little tip, if you shave it down, kind of like that is, just like, you know, basically cut it on an angle, it'll make it almost like a quill pen or a hypodermic needle. So grab your ferrofluid and touch it in the gap. Grab a little bit more. And you can see it, it's going to work its way all the way around. You don't have to go nuts with this stuff. This is the definition of a little dabble, do you? And this will probably be more than enough, that one big drop that's about to go on in there. And 99% of the time, it's going to automatically work its way around. But it's just fun to play with. Now, let's take a look, see if we can find the magnetic field in this. You see that? See how it's going to kind of go to the one spot and work its way around? If I were you, I wouldn't waste this stuff. But can I write with it? Speaking of quill pen. T. No, it's not going to let me write with it. So yeah, that pretty much covers it. You can now go ahead and put the rotor back in and reassemble as needed. I'm going to clean this mess up. And the last thing you want to be doing is taking a paper towel to this whole assembly after you just put the ferrofluid in, because you don't want to take any out of the gap and you've just basically been wasting ferrofluid. So with that being said, I hope you found this informative. It's very simple. A lot of people are pretty scared of it. Me personally, it's no different than working with any other type of seal on any type of reel. And now that Daiwa's coming out with a few new reels, I figured I'd bring this up because there may be some chatter on the interweb saying, oh, MagSeal's problematic, MagSeal sucks, blah, 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 it's impossible. I would never buy a reel that I can't service myself, etc., etc., etc. So, yeah, it's not that difficult to deal with. And this is one of the more complex MagSealed reels outside of their long cast designs available in the JDM market or Europe. So, I appreciate the time you guys spend here. Without you, I wouldn't be here. Make sure if you found this informative, definitely leave a like down below. And until next time, guys, tight lines, and I will see you soon.